Hi everyone, Ashlyn Keys, a YouTube channel. So today I'm just going to do like an update on myself, my life, and everything that's kind of been going on. So I used to do videos like every day, but now I just kind of do I'd say like I do in a week, I maybe do like one YouTube video or two YouTube videos. As opposed to like doing one video every day, just because, not because I can't come up with topics or because I don't want to, it's just because literally I've been so busy. So my first update thing that I want to talk to you guys about is that the fertility journey is like almost coming to an end for me and my husband, which is not exciting at all. But like, so here's what's going on. Last time I did an infertility video about everything that's been going on with our journey, I talked to you guys about how the doctor was going to give me like 3 more rounds of Clomid, and then if we weren't pregnant by then, she couldn't really do anything else. And so me and my husband talked about that, and we talked about what we are going to do like if we don't get pregnant within that time frame of those 3 rounds of Clomid. If you don't know what Clomid is, it's a fertility drug that helps women ovulate. So, I could not take it any Clomid this month because my doctor prescribed it too late. It's a very timely medication, so you have to take it like day 3 or 5 of your menstrual cycle, and it came after that day, so I couldn't take any this month, but it was probably for the better because my body needs like a rest. I've been taking infertility drugs for like 6 months now without a break, like without my body having a break. And I was taking letrozole, and letrozole is not only an infertility drug, but it's also a breast cancer treatment. So it's been really hard on my body. So that's another reason why I haven't really been on here. I've just been tired. That stuff makes you feel like crap. And so, yeah. So me and my husband talked, and our plan, if we don't get pregnant by then, is to go to a more natural infertility clinic where they work with you and they work with more natural methods. And relaxation techniques and stuff like that. So we're gonna try that. And if that doesn't work, then we're just gonna throw in the towel, sadly. Hold on 1 second. I gotta calm my son down because I can't even think of, like, what I'm saying with him doing this. He's 3 years old, and, so like, oh, that's made it harder to make YouTube videos too, because like he actually talks now, like says sentences and stuff. So he does this often. Hold on 1 second. Sorry. Okay. So our plan is to, throw in the towel after the natural, clinic, if that doesn't work. And then just, I'm going to start working out and getting on a diet and be very, very aggressive with that, because I have not been, to be honest with you guys, I have not been dieting at all. I haven't been, I mean, I've been cleaning my house. I still go out with my husband and my kids on the weekends, and we walk around stores in the mall and grocery shop and stuff like that. I'm not just like sitting all day, but like I have not been like working out or eating right. I've kind of just been eating whatever I want to and stuff like that. And I think that has a lot to do with like depression, because I get seasonal depression, and I am taking medicine and I am going to therapy and stuff like that. But it's just one of those times where like one of those sticky, stuck stagnation times where you feel like nothing's working. So like meaning like even though I take medications, even though I go to therapy, it feels like none of that is working. So I'm going to switch from eating whatever I want to being on a like a major diet. And major workout routine. Like working, starting out really slow, working out only like 15, 20 minutes a day to like 30 to 40 minutes a day, and then to a whole hour a day. And then when I hit an hour a day, that's when I'm going to cut the time limit and just keep it at an hour a day. But of course, I'm going to be moving faster because when I work out slow, when I first work out, start working out again, I move slowly. So like I'm not putting myself in cardiac arrest. And so I'm not like breathing like heavily and having an asthma attack because I have asthma. So I'm going to start out moving slow. And then as I lose weight and as my body gets used to working out, I'm going to start moving a little faster. And my plan is to get a treadmill. I used to have a treadmill at our old mobile home, but it got wrecked in the derecho of 2020 here in Iowa. So I have to go get a new one. So I'm planning on doing that. And another thing I wanted to talk to everybody about is like religion. Okay, so I believe in people believing in whatever they want to believe. I believe in loving everybody no matter what they believe in. I lately have came into a crossing with people who actually care about what I believe and can't just turn their cheek and mind their own business and just believe what they want to believe and let me believe what I want to believe when it comes to religion and spirituality and stuff like that. And I was watching YouTube videos and reading articles and stuff about Kat Von D, and I've always loved her from like TV shows and from her tattoo work and from just like reading articles about her. And like I wouldn't say like I loved her dark side per se, and I love her Christianity per se. Like either, I don't love either one, but I just loved her as a person in general. And I have to say that I can't, like, I totally understood how she felt when she was talking to everybody making a YouTube video about how people, like, she was getting kind of bashed, so to speak, from, like, non-Christians, but even more so from actual Christian people, because that just makes me feel so bad, because I can relate to her. Like, I at one point in my life was, like, doing Wicca and, like, not, like, hating God, but, like, was mad at God because there's so many shitty things that were happening in my life in the past. And if you guys don't know, like, some of the stuff that I've been through and stuff like that, go way back to my old videos and, like, just look through them and you'll see that I've been through some shit. And, so I got really mad at God at one point and, like, bitter towards people and God and just everything. And, like, it was much easier to be that way than it is to turn back to Jesus and be a Christian. But I did it a long time ago, many years ago, when me and my husband reunited and got married and stuff like that. And we've been together for like about 8 years now, total, from 2016 to now. And so I've been in working progress of turning back to Jesus and getting my faith back and being a Christian. And I have to tell you, it's not easy, and it's not something you can just like snap your fingers and be this Christian person. So I mean, and then there's some things that I just don't want to give up, to be honest. Like I like watching scary movies. I like like piercings, tattoos, and kind of weird things. Like I like haunted houses during Halloween and just things like that, and things that I don't want to give up. And I just feel like when Kat Von D was talking about like changes and sacrifices she was making, I feel that I understood her wholeheartedly, because making those changes is really hard. Also it makes it even harder when people are like bashing you and like acting like you can't dress a certain way or talk a certain way in order to be a Christian. I remember there was a part when she was talking about how she, like, when she was getting baptized, she was wearing all black and her friends were wearing black and stuff like that, and like I guess Christians were saying stuff about like this about that. And I just don't get it. I don't understand that. Why does it matter what the fuck color you wear or like how you dress or anything like that? Like you can be a Christian and not look like one, or maybe not really talk like one, or sometimes people might not even know you are one. I mean, you don't have, in my opinion, you don't have to look a certain way or talk a certain way to be a Christian. It's as simple as just believing that God died on the cross for our sins, and and you believe in the Bible, you believe in the Word, and you do your best to obey the Word and obey God, and you do your best to be Christian-like. And that's just it. You do the best you can. And because God knows our hearts and minds, He knows what we're thinking and what we're feeling. So the reason why I wanted to talk about that is because of the recent thing post over the last few weeks and months I've seen over Kat Von D. And also, I've been having troubles myself with Christians attacking me, and trying to act like they're above me, which is wrong, and actually quite frankly kind of evil in my opinion. But like, and things have been like so sad too, because as I'm like going towards this ending point with infertility, I'm holding on to the faith of a mustard seed for me and my husband to have a baby. But it's becoming like just really sad, and it's not fun anymore. And instead of like going to the clinic and getting my like blood drawn for my arm, I've just been peeing on those ovulation sticks. You can buy ovulation sticks offline or at a store or pharmacy, and you just pee in a cup, and you can dip the ovulation sticks in the cup, and you just wait for 5 minutes or what it says on the instructions, and it shows either no line or a thin line, like a faint line or a dark line. And if the line is the same color as the control line or darker than the control line, that means that you're on your way to ovulation, and like not 100%, because you can have like an LH surge and not ovulate. But like, I mean, majority of the time, if you get an LH surge, then that means it's a good indication that you could be ovulating. So it's not 100%, but I did do those ovulation sticks instead of going into the clinic and getting a progesterone level check, and it did show a peak. So hopefully I did ovulate, and I actually am dropped, like I dropped an egg, and that me and my husband are pregnant this time, because Otherwise, it's starting to kind of look like our family is complete and stuff like that. But it's so sad because it doesn't feel that way. It doesn't feel like our family's complete. It feels like it's incomplete and that there's one more child missing, because maybe just that's just because well, that's what we wanted, and we can't always get what we want in life. But it's been really hard too, because like a lot of my friends and family and people in this group that I have on social media and stuff like that, like a lot of people are having babies, and I see pictures and I see people being pregnant and stuff like that, and I am like truly happy for people, but it's hard for me, and it just makes me sad and stuff like that. So this, like, everything that's been going on lately has just been like draining, like really draining. And this has also been happening to me too. A lot of people have been coming to me, like text messaging me, Facebook messaging me, making comments on my YouTube channel, calling me on the phone and whatever, and talking to me and dumping all their problems on me. But I feel like I have no one to talk to. Like, to be honest with you, that's how I feel. I feel like I have nobody, not one person to talk to. Like, of course I can talk to my husband, but even there's subjects that he can't even understand. I'll give you guys some little like examples. Like, okay, he's never had anyone like that's really close to him pass away. So if I'm like missing somebody that I really love, which I am, I miss my dad and I miss like a lot of my friends and stuff like that during the holidays. And as you can see, Christmas is coming around the corner and all that's really hard for me, but like he can't understand that the way I am feeling, because he's never had anybody close to him pass away. There's a lot of things I've been through that he hasn't. So, like, if somebody hasn't been through stuff you've been through, and I've said this a lot in my videos, that's why probably a lot of people are starting to leave my YouTube channel or just don't watch my videos a whole lot, because some of it gets redundant. But if people are out there actually listening to what I'm saying, it's true. If somebody has not been through what you've been through, it makes it harder for them to understand what you are going through. That is the truth. So right now I'm just feeling like I'm misunderstood. Like I don't fit in anywhere, and I do see everything that's going on in my life right now. I'm stopping and smelling the flowers. I'm tearing up at my daughter's Lion King play that I just went to a week ago. I am gonna be going to my son's little elementary school singing concert, and probably tear up when I watch him on the stage singing. So I'm appreciating everything that's in my life and everything that's happening in my life and everything that I have, but it just feels like even though I'm appreciating everything in life and I'm doing everything the best that I can, I guess I don't feel heard or appreciated, loved, I don't know, any of that. Like, I do feel loved by God and I do feel heard by God, and that's about the only spirit, person that I know knows my heart and mind and can hear me. But when you're here on earth and you're still living, your human flesh life, it still gets tough even though you have God. There's a saying that I've heard, and I don't remember exactly how it goes, but I know that it goes something like, your worst days on earth are still, your worst days on earth are bad, but your worst days on earth with God are even better with him than they are without him. It's something like that. I can't remember. So I'm trying to look at life like that, like how if I didn't have God in my life, things would be even worse than what they are right now. Like my sadness and how I'm feeling and all that would be even worse. You would think that I would be like all cheerful and excited for Christmas and stuff like that, which I am. Like I said, I'm grateful and I'm enjoying life and I'm stopping and smelling the flowers, but there's just some things that are getting to me and I feel like nobody's understanding. That's kind of another reason why I slowed down on making YouTube videos, because I'm saying like really deep stuff. Like I'm talking about really deep shit, like abortions, abusive relationships, losing people and grieving. And I'm talking about plants and nature and fishing, but yet still nobody's hearing what I'm saying. So I don't know. I'm just gonna keep making videos for the same reasons that I've been making them before. For my family, for my kids, to vent, therapeutic reasons, stuff like that. And if I keep losing subscribers, or if no one's really getting what I'm saying, then I guess it'll have to be one of those things that later in life, what I'm saying will be understood. Maybe just not right now. So this was kind of just like a venting video and letting you guys know kind of what's been going on in my life. So yeah, I'm gonna wrap it up, but that's where we're at. Still no baby, still working on our house that we moved into, painting and doing little touch-up things to it. Taking care of our children and Christmas shopping. We had a great Thanksgiving with the family. It was very fun. Lots of talking and conversations, great food. Happy to see family. But I guess I feel like things can get better, and I'm hoping for better. So I'm just gonna do what I always tell everybody else to do, and I'm gonna stay in faith. So I will do more YouTube videos like I always do, and I will be on with another life topic.